Some remaining examples of the binomial distribution, as we have discussed earlier also, what were the uses or the application of probability, why we are all discussing about the probability. It was invented by, or it was discovered by, the mathematician, the great mathematician Blaise Pascal in the 17th century. And we can find out various applications of probability in gambling, as we discussed earlier, engineering, biology, economics, computer science, traffic control, medicine, agriculture, management of natural resources, etc. So this is all in the day-to-day life we come across with the examples or the problems for the modeling purpose, and with the knowledge of the probability or the random variable or the stochastic variable, whatever we are aware of, we try to find out the solution by keeping the things in the mind. So one of the question related to, again, the binomial distribution or the Bernoulli distribution. Now, in general, I have told you the various cases of the Bernoulli's or the binomial distribution, that it is mostly a distribution which is applicable to the discrete random variable. There is a categorization of the probability distribution, and binomial distribution is one of the type which is applicable to the discrete random variable. Now, discrete random variables means which are countably infinite. So, how many possibilities are always to be taken into consideration for the Bernoulli's or the binomial distribution? Two possibilities. Either head or tail. Either man will be alive or he will be dead. Either the answer is yes or the answer is no. So, accordingly, we will be having down the cases for the probability distributions in terms of binomial or Bernoulli. So this is an example related to it. An insurance salesman sells policies to 5 men, all of identical age and in good health. The probability that a man of this particular age will be alive 30 years is 2/3. So find the probability that in 30 years, all 5 men, at least 3 men, only 2 men, at the most 1 man, at least 1 man will be alive. So what is the probability provided to us for a man to be alive for 30 years? It is 2/3. So when a person will be dead, what will be the probability? That is a failure. So whatever is asked to us, that we will be consider it as a success. Okay? Always success or failure, positive or negative result mein mat dekhiye. Agar we are asked to find out the quantity or the requirement is accordingly to the data which is provided, that will be our success. Whatever is the probability given in this question is, for a particular age of a man, it will be alive for 30 years, that is our success. Because we are asked to calculate the probability in 30 years where it will be alive. Alive matches with the data which is provided in the question. So this will be our success. Whatever is the data provided in the question, that will be our success. The probability for a person to be alive 30 years is success, which is denoted by P. P is 2/3. So what will be Q? Q will be 1 minus P, because P plus Q is 1. So remaining quantity which will be failure. Abhi alive ka opposite kya hota hai? Dead. So what will be the probability for a person to be dead? It will be Q, which is 1 minus P. 1 minus 2/3 is 1/3. So in total, P plus Q becomes 1. All the 5 men. So out of the 5 men, what is number of people or person over here? N, which we used to call is, that is 5. Out of that, all the 5 men, uske liye probability nikalenge, at least 3. At least 3 means it can be greater than 3 also. Minimum it should be 3. But greater than 3, and what is our upper limit of men? It is 5. So at least 3 men will be 3, 4 and 5. Only 2 means exactly 2 men ke liye nikalenge. At the most 1 means maximum 1. Minimum is 0. Right? At least 1 means minimum 1. Highest can be 5. So accordingly, we will be calculating the probability. I hope the terminologies are clear for the at least, at the most, and or in probability. And accordingly, we can calculate and get the answer. So we have number of trials n is equal to 5 means number of men. In total, how many men are there? 5. Probability of success P to be alive is 2 by 3. And what will be the failure then correspondingly Q, which is 1 minus P. 1 minus 2 by 3 is 1 by 3. Probability for all 5 men means random variable is X is equal to 5. Our formula is NCX P to the power X into Q to the power N minus X. N is 5. X is also 5 because pure 5 people ke liye mujhe five men, probability for success is 2 by 3 to the power 5, failure is 1 by
3. Yes, sir.
Next is for at least 3 men. For at least 3 men means X is minimum 3, greater than 3 bhi chalega. Abhi X is greater than equal to 3, but in total I have N is equal to 5. So it will be probability X equal to 3 plus probability X equal to 4 plus probability X equal to 5. For X is equal to 3, it will be 5C3, 2 by 3 to the power 3, 1 by 3 to the power 5 minus 3, that is 2. 5C4, 2 by 3 to the power 4, 1 by 3 to the power 5 minus 4 is 1. 5C5, 2 by 3 to the power 5, 1 by 3 to the power 0. This calculation comes out to be 192 upon 243. Only 2 men. Only 2 means X is equal to 2. 5C2, 2 by 3 to the power 2, 1 by 3 to the power. Kya hona chahiye yahan par? 5 minus 2, it should be 3. This should be 5 minus 2 is 3. So accordingly, whenever you have 5 minus 2 as 3, so we will be getting down the answer as 40 upon 243. At most one man means X is less than or equal to 1. Abhi less than or equal to 1 means 0 and 1. Only two possibilities are there. So accordingly, you get the simplification that will be giving you 11 by 243 as the answer. At least 1 means X is greater than equal to 1. Means probability at X equal to 1, X equal to 2, X equal to 3, X equal to 4, X equal to 5. So this becomes a tedious calculation. Whenever you have at most one man calculation, I can have easily 1 minus the opposite thing so that you can easily calculate. Greater than equal to 1 means 1 onwards. Only whatever is what is left out in that, X equal to 0 is left out. So 1 minus probability at X equal to 0, universal mein se X equal to 0 nikal denge, to all bacha hua kya rahega? 1, 2, 3, 4. 5. So that is how I will be trying to calculate. Otherwise, you can calculate it for probability X equal to 1, X equal to 2, X equal to 3, X equal to 4, and X equal to 5. Can calculate the things in that way also, but that will either clear or any calculation. So ideal कहीं पर बोला भी नहीं रहेगा. But only whenever you have only two options, only when you have two options available for the calculation, that is either probability of success or probability of failure, then only by default we will be applying the binomial or Bernoulli's expansion or the बर्नौलीज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, बाइनोमियल एक्सपेंशन पर से ही अपन ने ये डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन का फॉर्मूला निकाला हुआ है। इन अ फैमिली ओनली पॉसिबिलिटी इज द चाइल्ड कैन बी अ बॉय और अ गर्ल। इन द टॉसिंग ऑफ द कॉइन द पॉसिबिलिटी इज ओनली द हेड और द टेल। सो इन ऑल सच केसेस व्हेन वी हैव ओनली टू ऑप्शंस अवेलेबल वी ट्राई टू अप्लाई द बर्नौलीज और द बाइनोमियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। वन मोर एग्जाम्पल रिलेटेड टू बर्नौलीज और द बाइनोमियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, अ डिस्क्रीट रैंडम वेरिएबल एक्स इज बाइनोमियली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड। Here it is mentioned with mean 6 and variance as 2. Find the probability that 5 less than equal to x less than equal to 7. The mean is nothing but mu and variance is nothing but sigma, which is given by NP and NPQ. In the previous class, we discussed various properties. What are the various properties? The mean value of x mu is NP. The variance of x is sigma square, which is NPQ. And in this particular example also, I am provided with the same information. What is that same information? Mean is equal to 6 and variance is equal to 2. The probability that we have to calculate the probability for the random variable x, which is greater than equal to 5 and less than equal to 7. The mean and variance of binomial distribution are respectively given by NP and NPQ. So NP is equal to 6, NPQ is equal to 2. So Q will be equal to 2 by 6, which is 1 by 3. And 1 minus Q will be given by P, which is 2 by 3. So probability of P kitna aa gaya, which is success, usually we consider 2 by 3. Probability of failure, which is Q usually, is 1 by 3. NP is equal to 6. P mujhe pata hai, 2 by 3. So N is equal to kitna ho gaya? 9, which is number of trials. Right? So mujhe abhi N pata hai, P pata hai, Q pata hai. Probability to be calculated between 5 to 7, both inclusive. Means X is equal to 5, X is equal to 6. X is equal to 7. NC 5, P to the power X, Q to the power N minus X. 9 minus 5 is 4. Q is 1 by 3. P is 2 by 3. Similarly for 6, similarly for 7, that answer comes out to be 0.7121. So that is how we try to obtain the answer in this fashion. So I hope this particular example is also clear. In case wherein we are provided with the variance as well.